Alright, what is good everybody? It's your boy John Denton, JD the Prophet, back with another album reaction. And goodness me, this has to be the most requested thing on my channel at the moment by some distance. Yes, I'm going into IGOR, Tyler the Creator. It had to happen, absolutely had to happen. So if you're new to the channel, make sure you're subscribing, make sure you're hitting the like button, whether you're new or not. Now we're going to be going through track by track, having a little chat about what we think on the way through. You know, obviously you heard Earthquake before, but that's about it. So yeah, very, very excited to listen to this project. I know a lot of people are keen to see this video. So yeah, excited, let's get going. Straight in with Igor's theme. Headphones on, let's go. Much going on in the production there, from the synths to the weird plingly prangly things on a siren in the background here. Yeah, so much going on there, and it sounds like live drums as well. Sounds amazing. This has all been arranged and produced by himself, right? I'm correct in saying that, right? Yeah, amazing. Ooh. I'm going to pause it just before the end of the track because I know people say the transitions between the tracks on this album are amazing. So I'm going to try not to pause in between each track. What a statement of intent for an opening track from somebody who's quote unquote a rapper and has been for so long. Statement of intent are basically, give or take, lyricless opener that's just all instrumental. Then moves from those foreboding synths into the kind of funky jazzy drums almost. Then the other stuff coming in, and then the piano and no lyrics whatsoever basically, apart from a few words here and there. Yeah, and obviously we'll know what's coming as well. So obviously if you want to see the first true full reaction to this, it's over on Rock Reacts. This is the one that we did off the album with the video. But yeah, it's been in my head ever since, as I'm sure it has for everybody else as well. Make my earthquake. Riding around, you love me shaking me. You slide, you all at the club, huh? And she weak, huh? Yeah, like Wolf Vicky, huh? Yeah, oh my God, huh? Oh, I'm not Timmy, huh? Yeah, honestly, that little soliloquy from Playboi Carti there, God knows what the hell he's saying. I've no idea. I never do. But that's, honestly, it's changed my mind a little bit on that ice, because that sounds so good with the stripped back piano and everything like that. It's like, it makes me kind of appreciate what he is in a slightly different way. I'm not saying I'm a fan yet, but very different to when I first heard him, how I think of him now. Ooh, yeah. I know what people are saying about transitions now. I don't know where I'm going, but I know what I'm showing. Feelings, that's what I'm pulling. Okay, say it, get it. Okay, wait a minute. I drip that shit, I am on. Walk curiosity, keep the feeling gone. I was getting Childish Gambino heartbeat vibes from the beginning in the verse there, but obviously much softer chorus. But yeah, another production is just ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous.
exactly what you run from, you end up chasing. Like, you can't avoid, but just chasing it and just, like, trying, giving it everything that you can. There's always an obstacle. Running out of time, running out of time, running out of time. Running out of time. Fight. I've been running out of spells.
Thematically, this is all linking brilliantly, and like the way that music is sort of playing between the tracks. What am I trying to say? Like the way that the musically and thematically it's linking between the tracks. I thought it was going to be a little trio at the beginning, but yeah, this is also flowing straight into this. Really quite amazing the way it flows together. So I don't want to stop it too much, but obviously you can't just sit here and just go like this and call that a video. Are you? Come on. I'm lying for these niggas, stop lying to yourself. I know the real you. Holla when they fall, man, they lose the costume. You need to chill, okay. I'm running from the targets in the back in the day. And now they rocking the R, now they tracking the dog. Again, I'm going to pause it just before the end to let the transition run. So I'm guessing this feels like a little bit of, it's not quite as light and breezy as the other ones. And with the car going around, it creates a sense of... the speed of tension of exactly running out of time, like a kind of frantic nature to it, which is juxtaposed a little bit with the rest of the music, but also maybe it's slightly sort of talking to himself in the mirror a little bit. Right, on to new magic wand.
Sometimes you gotta close the door to open a window.
Here we go. I saw a photo, you look joyous. My eyes are green, I eat my veggies. I need to get her out the picture. And I want 100 of your time, your mind. Sinister, everything about it is just sinister.
Hey, yo. Take one look in the mirror, implications so clear. I live life with no fear, except for the idea that one day you won't be here. But I got wig on my chest that I need to get off right talking to them. Can't be in the picture if you got no frame. I'll let the world know because I ain't got no shame. Blow the whole spot up because I want to share last names. I want to be
sneaking some bars in there. Sneaking some bars in there finally on track 6. I got a plan about a walk in the pen. If you can't understand, I'll be a hawk in the gym. Eyes and a prize. Got weight on my chest that I need to get off around talking to them. Bars. You're number one, not the other one. Keep it on the low. I'm in my right mind. Keep it on the high. Right, into a boy with a gun. Ooh. Yeah. Position.
Okay. Don't shoot me down. You so motherfucking dangerous. You so motherfucking dangerous. You got me by my neck.
You know, you're killing me with that Kanye West style production with the high pitched, switched up samples every time. Every time. Body senses, got me on the fences. Whole squad and gym, the travel bag by Balenciaga. Big dog hitting big willies on the 6 feet. Don't shoot me down. You so motherfucking dangerous. So motherfucking dangerous. You got me by my neck. So I start to think it's lame as fuck. This is a whole vibey, wavy song, but then again, like, you listen to the lyrics and it's like, again, sinister. There's a lot going on, a lot of jealousy, a lot of feeling threatened, the relationship's turning a bit toxic. Thematically coherent. I mean, this album is so thematically coherent. Musically and lyrically.
Don't shoot me down.
again, I paused it just before the transition. Yeah, chaotic all over the place, that song. Weird, a difficult listen with the repeated refrain going over and over again. A good track, definitely. But yeah, you can tell this relationship's going very bad very quickly.
Ayo. I wanna talk, I wanna call you and talk. I wanna walk to your front door and knock. After I stop, my vehicle drive to your city, cause we live an hour apart. I am starting to wonder, is this my free will or yours? Yours, yours, yours.
Ooh.
I'm your puppet. You control me.
I was going to say, was that Kanye in there? I thought it was, so I just checked where I was going. And of course, yeah, it is Kanye. I mean, there's a lot of Kanye on this album generally, but yeah, I see him make a little appearance there. Makes sense as well. It's a siren, right? It's pretty dark.
But at some point, you come to your senses.
And so what's good?
Ass niggas, I just get my mic on. Y'all said I wouldn't go nowhere, I took the detour. When you see the sun on a crack rock by the seashore. Yeah, yeah.
Ooh.
Let's go, I ain't right. Playing around. Red nose, all you niggas clown. Had them niggas in the cops looking jigsaw. I done fucked around and turned into the big dog. Better kick off, get caught, bitch, I think not.
Hard, it's hard.
I see the light.
Don't touch, go.
I see the light.
Light.
I see the light.
Crazy, dude. Crazy track.
Being okay with it.
It's a rock beat.
Come here and scarf me for dinner. Jump off the roof into the mirror, felt like summer. I know my temperature was set. You finally flew south to Berg, on me the next shock, I'm at it. At least I had it.
The contrast. That last soul was terrifying. Ooh, ah, in the production. Fucking hell. I did it into an indie rock song. A 6 minute indie rock song at that, so maybe it's going to be one of those two songs in one type deals.
My love's gone. My love's gone.
Yeah. Transition, getting a bit funky, a bit disco-y almost.
Not, I'm not shocked I brought this on me. It's my fault you gon' leave. Listen, talk, see the weatherman told me it wasn't raining. My stupid ass brought umbrellas. I got a glimpse of your cloud and felt better. Now it's 90 degrees and all the tricks of my sleeve. And turned it into a fence that my building got tore down. All because of your new tenant, I'll just buy some new shit. Everything.
Like, I hate wasted potential. That shit crushes your spirit. It really does. It crushes your soul.
Who was that talking just then? Let me know. amazing track. Amazing track. Given everything that's come before as well. Straight into I Don't Love You Anymore.
See,
makes sense.
Heavy feelings for you, yeah, it's no secret. You too cool for me, and I ain't trying to. I just took the piece up. I ain't trying to keep up because I don't love you anymore.
I thought, given the title of this song, it was going to be a genuine kind of closure to the relationship that they talk about in the whole album. The title talks about in the album, but there's some self-doubt in there. There's some kind of mania in there in the delivery of the I Don't Love You Anymore. So maybe it's not quite as finished as in his mind as he wants it to be. But given his obsession with her slash his ex in the earlier tracks, you know, none of this is particularly healthy.
Something my feelings and I lost the family. This just might be better for us, you know.
Chaotic and very manic. Manic energy on that track. Really manic. I thought, given 10, this was going to be just a smooth outro to the rest of this album. But now it's back to that sinister edge, the mania. So are we still fret? Yeah, that makes sense. Like, still kind of wants an in coming up. Alright, last track. Are we still friends? So those last two tracks, right? I get why they were there. They tie into the story of the album. There's a seagull yelling in the background. You can probably hear that. But I think it would have been better if it had just ended. Gone, slash thank you was such a perfect ending to an almost flawless record. And then those two, they were too chaotic, both of them. Like I said, I get why they were there thematically. I get why they were there narratively. And, you know, who am I to question the title of the creator's musical decisions? But for me, I would probably end it at 10. And when I listen through again, honestly, I'll probably stop after 10. Maybe those songs will grow on me. Let me know your thoughts on them. But everything before that was almost perfect. Regardless, stunning album, thematically coherent, thematically brilliant, not too dense and complicated. I like the fact that it told a story musically, not just through lyrics. And yeah, amazing to see an artist, not that I've heard all his back catalogue, but I've heard enough, to come from off the wall, unusual bars, basically beats bars, kind of shocking, controversial rap music, to a concept love album about a relationship that, you know, dives into disco and funk and soul and R&B and rock and roll and indie, as well as you know, still having some of that dark synthy 808 heavy bassy rap music in there as well. A real enigma, a real special talent. People say at the moment that music's in a bad state, rap music's in a bad... nonsense, absolute nonsense. It's broader and more beautiful and brilliant than it's ever been. What a pleasure again. I mean, it really has been a treat going on this journey for all these albums and listening to them. You know, there's a reason that you guys keep recommending me certain albums to listen to, because chances are I'm going to like them. There's definitely some brilliance in that. There's definitely some brilliance in that, and I think it's only going to get better the more I listen to it. So yeah, that's it. Done. I will go back and do older Tyler, the Creator stuff. I know we're saving a few tracks for Rock Reacts as well. So we don't make sure that we're getting those pure reactions over there to those tracks. But yeah, as always, guys, you've made it all the way to the end with me on this one. You just got to leave an I made it down in the comments. You know, the more those I see, the more rewarding it is for me. And it's always amazing that people are going to come and sit, watch these whole reactions with me. Thank you very much for watching. My name's been John Denton, and still is John Denton, JD the Prophet, Big Prof. If you're new to the channel, please do subscribe, let other people know what's going on here. Make sure you leave a thumbs up, let me know what sort of stuff you want me to be reacting to next, and your thoughts on the album as well, because, you know, the endless recommendations can get a little bit like white noise after a while across all the different platforms and the two channels. So, yeah, just let me know your thoughts on the album as well. I love to read all that stuff. That's about it, guys. So we'll be doing more of these going forward, and make sure you're checking out the live streams as well over here. I've been John Denton, like I said. I'll catch you on the next one. Oh, follow me on social media, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.